In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, and welcome to our online Mass on Mission Sunday from St. Brigid's Chapel, Kilcurry, Forgot Parish. Let us offer this Mass for Mary and John McCardell and the deceased family members, Julia, Michael and Mary Cunningham, Vincent and Bridget Holsgrove and the deceased family members, Patsy Harrison, Willie Quigley, Michelle Flynn and Matthew Flynn, Patricia McShane, Owen Fohey and the deceased family members, Peggy McGillan, Jerry McGuinness, Una Matthews, David O'Connor, Frank Lennon, late of Scotch Green, and the deceased family members, Maura Martin, Terry and Amy Kelly, Betty McNally, James Hughes, and the deceased family members, Jerry, Martha, and Eddie Campbell, Pat and Eileen Rome, Baby, Mairead Rosie Kelly, and Jim Quigley, whose anniversaries occur at this time. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them, and may they rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading, a reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whom he has taken by his right hand to subdue nations before him and strip the loins of kings, to force gateways before him, that their gates may be closed no more. It is for the sake of my servant Jacob, of Israel, my chosen one, that I have called you by your name, conferring a title, though you do not know me. I am the Lord, unrivaled. There is no other God besides me. Though you do not know me, I arm you that men may know from the rising to the setting of the sun, that apart from me, all is nothing. This is the word of the Lord. Response Oriel Psalm. Give the Lord glory and power. O sing a new song to the Lord. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Tell among the nations his glory and his wonders among all peoples. Give the Lord glory and power. The Lord is great and worthy of praise, to be feared above all gods. The gods of the heavens are not. It was the Lord who made the heavens. Give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord, you families, all people, of all peoples, give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord the glory of his name. Bring an offering and enter his courts. Give the Lord glory and power. Worship the Lord in his temple. O earth, tremble before him. Proclaim to the nations, God is King. He will judge the peoples in fairness. Give the Lord glory and power. Second reading, a reading from St. Paul's first letter to the Thessalonians. From Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy to the church in Thessalonica, which is in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, wishing you grace and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We always mention you in our prayers and thank God for you all, and constantly remember before God our Father how you have shown your faith in action, worked for love and preserved through hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. We know, brothers, that God loves you and that you have been chosen, because when we brought the good news to you, it came to you not only as words, but as power and as the Holy Spirit and utter conviction. This is the word of the Lord. Gospel acclamation.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The Pharisees went away to work out between them how to trap Jesus in what he said, and they sent their disciples to him together with the Herodians to say, Master, we know that you are an honest man and teach the way of God in an honest way, and that you are not afraid of anyone, because a man's rank means nothing to you. Tell us your opinion then. Is it permissible to pay taxes to Caesar or not? But Jesus was aware of their malice and replied, You hypocrites, why do you set this trap for me? Let me see the money you pay the tax with. They handed him a denarius, and he said, Whose head is this? Whose name? Caesar's, they replied. He then said to them, Very well, give back to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God. The Gospel of the Lord. Continuing our reading of Matthew chapter 22 today, the Pharisees are not impressed with Jesus' teachings and decide to entrap him, accusing him about paying taxes. It is a dangerous question they ask, because a simple yes or no response from Jesus could mean he is reported to the authorities. Jesus has no time for this and is quite direct with them, asking, why are you putting me to the test, you hypocrites? The response is brilliant. Give to the emperor that are emperors, and to God the things that are God's. This text has sometimes been used to argue that religion should stay out of politics, economics, and culture. However, the world we live in is one that falls short of the vision and values which Jesus preached, a dream of a world of love, peace, justice, and compassion. Being a follower of Jesus means that one is actively involved in striving for this vision, and this includes whatever political, economic, or cultural issues we are confronted with. The focus in this passage is getting our priorities right. Yes, give the emperor his taxes, but do not forget what belongs to God, that is God's vision for this world. The empirical view and the Christ view of issues like direct provision, homelessness, evictions, the Black Lives Matter movement, climate action are usually very different. The Pharisees, we are told, were amazed and left him and went away. Let us make the profession of our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Gracious Lord, acknowledging that all good things come from you, and knowing of your infinite love and generosity, we humbly bring our prayers to you.
On this World Mission Sunday, we pray for our church that it be renewed in its mission to reveal the Word of God to all His peoples. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We ask God to bless all our missionaries who have dedicated their lives to spreading Christ's message of love and salvation throughout the world. We pray also for the families who nurtured them, the missionary families that supported them, and all those communities abroad who received and welcomed them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all parents in their role as missionaries to their children, and we ask the Lord to bless the work of all in promoting the word of Jesus Christ in our society, our parishes, and our schools. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that we, as followers of Christ, recognize that we too are missionaries and must promote his message with friends, family, and neighbours through our words and actions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for responsibility in our community, that all in it accept the sacrifices which are essential to bring themselves, their families, and their neighbours safely through the COVID-19 pandemic. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We bow our heads and remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember and pray for Mary and John McArdle and the deceased family members, Julia, Michael and Mary Cunningham, Vincent and Brigid Hallsgrove and the deceased family members, Patsy Harrison, Willie Quigley, Michelle Flynn and Matthew Flynn, Patricia McShane, Owen Fahey and the deceased family members, Peggy McQuillan, Ní Gearnan, Jerry McGuinness, Una Matthews, David O'Connor, Frank Lennon and the deceased family members, Maura Martin, Terry and Amy Kelly, Betty McNally, James Hughes and the deceased family members, Jerry, Martha and Eddie Campbell, Pat and Eileen Rowe, Baby Maria Rose Kelly and Jim Quigley, for whom this Mass is being offered. We also remember and pray for Father Bernard Hughes, who died recently, that they may have a share in the promised hope of your eternal love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. We pray through the intercession of Mary as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of your own Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. God, our Father, inspire us to be true missionaries of your word. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hands. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Eamon and Michael, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Mary and John McArdle, and the deceased family members, Julia, Michael, and Mary Cunningham, Vincent and Brigid Holsgrove, and the deceased family members, Patsy Harrison, Willie Quigley, Michelle Flynn and Matthew Flynn, Patricia McShane, Owen Fohey and the deceased family members, Peggy McWillan, Nee Gernan, Jerry McGuinness, Una Matthews, David O'Connor, Frank Lennon and the deceased family members, Maura Martin, Terry and Amy Kelly, Betty McNally, James Hughes and the deceased family members, Jerry, Martha and Eddie Campbell, Pat and Eileen Rome, Baby Maria Rose Kelly, Anjim Yukilim, whom you have called from this world to yourself, grant that they who were united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints, Saint Brigid, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us, who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Say.